Hey there, welcome back to my channel. My name is Megan. Welcome to another living room refresh slash living room makeover. It is actually the second one I've done in a year. Let me explain. I got a little Pinterest happy. I did a living room refresh and I just didn't love it. It took me a few months to realize what was going on, and ever since then I've been trying to figure out exactly what I want to do with this room, and I finally figured it out. If you'd like to stay up to date with my projects in real time, make sure you follow me over on Instagram. I am at Megan Bell Made. We are in the middle of a pandemic, so places like Home Goods, Target, places that I normally peruse to buy new, you know, home decor are really low in stock right now. So I had to be creative with this and I didn't make a lot of purchases. I actually only bought a couple of things. I will link everything that I can below in the description box, including the things that I purchased and anything else that I have that I can find a link for, just in case you're interested. Now first, let me show you what the living room looked like before. I had navy blue walls. I had all of my furniture pushed up against the walls. I had a rug that was just enormous in the middle of it, a giant coffee table. Everything was facing the mantle and our shelving, and we had our TV over the mantle. And I thought that this was the best way to configure our furniture at the time. After really thinking about it, I realized that I wanted to just switch everything around. And so I did. I repainted our living room. I used Sherwin-Williams Aesthetic White, and it's a beautiful color. I use it throughout my home. It pops really, really nicely against our white trim, which, by the way, I have installed all of our ceiling trim in our house. I will have a link to that video below if you're interested in doing that. It's sort of a farmhouse style trim alternative to crown molding. I got new curtain rods and curtains for our living room. They're very budget friendly. A new chandelier, which is a dupe for a Pottery Barn chandelier that costs about four times the amount I paid. I rearranged our furniture so that it is facing each other, which you see in a lot of Instagram pictures, but I wasn't really convinced would really work for our living room until I asked my husband to help me actually move everything and kind of really look at it. And I think it works so wonderfully. The one thing that really makes it work is that we have put our TV on the other side of the room. It's no longer over our fireplace mantle. And this kind of helps prevent that side of the room from feeling so crowded. You know, we had the shelving, the fireplace, the TV. It just felt like a lot was on that wall. So we've kind of divided everything and it really feels like the room is more balanced. Once I moved the TV to the other side of the room, I realized I needed a nice big credenza to go underneath it to house all of our electronics. We have a ton of electronics, and I have my record player and my records and all of those things inside of it. And so I needed something really big, and I decided to make my own, which is kind of crazy, but I love the way it came out. I have a video for it, a tutorial, and I will have that linked below. And it's perfect because it's enormous, so it holds everything that we need it to hold. The top of it has become sort of a plant ledge. I didn't intend for that, but I have so many plants that I keep outdoors in the summertime, and I'm slowly starting to move them back in now that the weather is changing. And so this is where I've put a lot of them. I also moved my bird of paradise in, and I have that over here, which is getting plenty of sunlight and it's beautiful. And then my fiddle leaf fig, which I've had for a couple years now, is just really taking over. I'm not sure I love it in this exact spot, but it's where it's going to stay until I figure out a better place for it. We've had our couch for like 4 years now. I actually just wrote a blog post all about this couch. I will link that below. I love this couch. It's the most kid-friendly white couch that I have ever owned, and I've owned a couple of white couches. I think it's so easy to keep clean. It's super comfortable, it's enormous, and we just absolutely love it. So I have that sort of facing these two chairs that we purchased from Restoration Hardware. All of our furniture is sort of low, which is nice because we have a child and he's able to get on and off of them very easily. I just stuck two pillows that I had from Home Goods in there. And then in the middle, we have our round coffee table. We got rid of the other coffee table and we purchased this one from Wayfair. It's actually an open box item. It did come with a little scratch on the top, which was totally fine with me because we have a child, and I'm sure that there will be more scratches on it eventually. I don't keep a lot of decor on it. It's usually our play area, so I just have a couple of coasters, some books, and a candle, but oftentimes that isn't even on there because, like I said, we use this as a play area very often. We have a basket in here that I usually just keep a blanket on top, but it houses all of my son's toys, and it's a great place to actually keep his toys because he is able to access them very easily, and he's also able to clean them up at the end of the day, and then I don't have a bunch of toys sitting out. It's not unsightly. I like our home to look comfortable and cozy, but I don't want it to look overtaken by children. This gold hammered side table that I have, I got from World Market a couple years ago. It's really great because you can actually store, it's hollow, completely hollow, and you can store things inside of it. So I keep a lot of our more unsightly things in here, extra candles and things that I'm just trying to hide. As far as the fireplace mantle goes, it was probably the most difficult thing for me to decorate because I needed the perfect mirror to go on it. And I did try to find some mirrors on Facebook Marketplace, but I just could not find anything. I was willing to paint it, to sand it, whatever, but I couldn't find anything that was going to work. So I ended up finding this mirror at Target, and it was very affordable. I think it looks perfect. It's a little bit on the skinny side, so I just decorated around it with some vases and dried florals in there. I have my pampas grass and then some found and foraged florals. The shelves probably took me the longest to decorate because I was convinced that I needed to buy new decor, but everything that I have on my shelves, I have had and owned for years. I used books, and I just turned them around if they were a little bit unsightly, and that is a new trend that's happening right now. All of everybody's books are backwards, and I'm on board with it because it allows me to keep some of my uglier books that I want to reread and keep them on display. I have a few picture frames that I had already had. We had this huge gallery wall in the living room before, so some of these pictures are from that gallery wall. Some driftwood that I found locally, some plants, and just other just sort of knick-knack things. These shelves are so big that I have to be very careful about putting a lot of smaller items on them. I think I made that mistake last time I redid our living room. And also I kind of crowded things together. So I was really careful this time about keeping things more spaced apart. I did do some thrifting when I decorated these shelves, like this basket here I found at a local thrift store, and I just spray painted it gold. These vases I had sitting around already in the house, I painted them with some chalk paint, and I just foraged some grass and leaves from around my neighborhood. I laid them out to dry for a day or two and stuck them in here. These palms that I have in here, I actually got from A Floral. I'll link those below. They're beautiful, and I think they're such high quality, and they're not very pricey. So those are nice to have just kind of stuck in there, but I did not want to spend a ton of money on dried florals. So I took my chance in foraging them, and it really worked out. And also these candlesticks I bought on Facebook Marketplace. They were like a rose gold color, only paid like $10 for them, and I just spray painted them black. I love Facebook Marketplace. I highly recommend it if you're planning to redecorate your space to look on there before you buy something new. We have a new rug in the living room. The other rug that we had was a 9x12. It actually was too big. So this is only an 8x10, and it's perfect. I got it from Serena and Lily. It was on the pricier side, and I looked at this rug for like a year before I actually pulled the trigger. I thought it was too expensive, but when I received it, I realized it was worth every penny. I probably will never buy a cheap, or I should say inexpensive rug again, because I see the difference now that I have a pricier rug. It is so thick, it is so cozy, and it will last us for years. And I feel that if I ever change my taste and decide to sell it, that I'll be able to get a good chunk of my money back. Thank you. for watching. I absolutely love my living room now. I feel like it actually reflects my personality and my true design taste. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope it inspires you to make over your space, and I will see you guys next time.